Hi, friends. It's Deanna Willison with our Blooming Catholic Life. And this is Friday, week three of our Lectio Divina study on Matthew 19. We are looking at verses 9 through 12. And every time I look at this, I do get something different. And what has really struck me, what struck me, it's probably not at all what struck you, but what struck me was the thought of spiritual, the metaphysical reality of this passage, and the thought of my God children, as well as my spiritual children, and am I really praying and fasting and almsgiving for them? Some may be moved to pray and fast for holy marriage or for those who take the vow of celibacy. Beautiful practices all. Some may be praying this week for those who are discerning these different calls. All beautiful things to take from this. And as I've passed through the week looking at this, a week for you, it's been moments for me. The passage of those who have made themselves eunuch. And in verse 12, it's made themselves eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven. But we all know in this age, there are those who are making themselves eunuchs for what? For what? And so today I'm going to ask you, I'm going to specifically request you to add a prayer, at least while today, maybe after you've done this, or maybe we can just pray. Let's just pray now, friends. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Dear Lord, we come before you. We come before you, Father, because of these words of your Son, Jesus, talking to us about marriage and eunuchs, and just, Lord, we want to ask. We're just going to ask for the graces for people to have the strength and the courage to discern their vocation, as well as those who are in the marriage state or taking a vow of celibacy, that they may keep these vows that they have made both to you and to others. Lord, I'm going to ask for all those graces, but Lord, I'm going to ask for something else. I want to ask for you a blessing on all of our spiritual children, on all of our God children, and especially, Lord, on those children, adults, who we can maybe spiritually adopt right now, Lord, those who have made themselves eunuchs, not for the kingdom, but those who have made themselves eunuchs in the name of transgenderism, in the name of pride, who are seeking some kind of peace in this world, Lord, but not the peace that you can give. They are trying to manufacture peace by chopping up healthy body parts and mutilating themselves, their bodies. They're taking hormones that are for another gender. They are taking puberty-blocking hormones. Lord, they are harming themselves in so many ways, but they are seeking you, Lord. They are seeking the peace that only you have. And so, Lord, we're just going to beg that we can have this opportunity more often to pray for these poor souls, and that you will send graces upon them, grace upon grace upon grace, because of course, Lord, we know they are free to refuse you. They are free to turn away from you. So we're going to keep asking you to send them graces and chance after chance, and people in their lives who will just love on them, just radiate your love to them, Lord, so that they may come, they may turn to you in all humility, Lord, and beg you for that peace which only you hold. We're just going to ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen, Lord. In nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Let us get to our verses now, friends. Again, we're going to pray St. Francis' prayer before the crucifix, which in Latin is Oratio ante crucifixum dicta. Summe glorioso Deus, illumina tenebras cordis mihi, et da mihi fidem rectum spem certin et caritatem perfectum, Domini ut facium tuum sanctum et verax mandatum. Amen. And I say to you, that whosoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committeth adultery. And he that shall marry her that is put away, committeth adultery. His disciples say unto him, If the case of a man with his wife be so, it is not expedient to marry. Who say to them, All men take not this word, but they to whom it is given. For there are eunuchs who are born so from their mother's womb, and there are eunuchs who were made so by men. There are eunuchs who have made themselves eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven. He that can take, let him take it. Again, friend, my hearts are breaking for some of those people who are in this situation. They may feel that they were eunuchs born so from their mother's womb. And maybe they were. Does that mean that they should mutilate healthy body parts and put their physical health at risk? No, friends. No, please, please, please stop. I know it's a challenge for you and it can be hard and it's difficult, but I ask you to see supports in ways that do not harm you. There is help out there for you. And you may not ever, ladies, want to have children, those who were born female. Those who are born male may never, not ever want to have children as well. And that can be okay if that's what you need. Seek direction on that and what that looks like. You may still find that you change your mind one day. And so mutilating body parts is not the way to go. Going artificially to have children, also not the way to go. And some of you may be hurting. You may say, I'm like a eunuch. And that I can't have biological children. I will encourage you to look up NAPRO technologies, NAPRO. A lot of times there are things that are actually wrong with your biological system. And so many of the treatments of modern medicine address symptoms, not causes. And so they cannot cure it. But oftentimes there is a cure. There is help. So don't give up yet. Find a NAPRO technology specialist. You may also find them by looking up pro-life gynecologist or obstetrician. You could find it that way as well. They're not necessarily overlapping. There's not, those terms aren't used interchangeably, but that can be a hope for you. And sorry, this is just so much on my mind. Both, and let's have some mercy on those who were divorced against their will. We have no fault divorce now, and you can only fight it so long, friends. And I know so many people who were divorced again against their will who have remained celibate, and that is a challenge for them. And so I'm just going to ask for blessings and graces for them on this difficult road as well. God bless them. And I say to you that whosoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committeth adultery. And he that shall marry her that is put away, committeth adultery. His disciples say unto him, if the case of a man with his wife be so, it is not expedient to marry. Who said to them, all men take not this word, but they to whom it is given. For there are eunuchs who were born so from their mother's womb, and there are eunuchs who were made so by men, and there are eunuchs who have made themselves eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven. He that can take it, let him take it. Friends, may God bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you and to be gracious unto you. And may the good Lord bless you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.